So the next card I'm testing here is the MSI GTX 580 Ti 448 edition. This is almost as fast as a GTX 570, but slightly cut down. Back to 3D Mark 11 to start with, and then we'll move to 3D Mark Vantage later on. I've got two of these. I've got this MSI one here and a EVGA classified one as well, but I haven't fully tested the classified one yet, so I might not SLI it with this one just yet until I've fully tested it. I've still got the Elmore EVC 2S hooked up to the Asus Rampage 4 board, and we're still running a Intel Xeon E5-1680V2, that's an 8 core 16 thread CPU at 4.75 GHz. So obviously I'm running 3D Mark 11, it's getting about 40 FPS right now. So for those people who don't know or watched the last video of what the EVC 2S does, basically plugs into a header on the motherboard next to the start button over there, and it reads the VRM temperatures, power output and voltage, things like that, straight from the voltage controller on the motherboard. So on my laptop down here you can see I've got a real-time output of what the CPU is doing. So even though I've got 1.4 something volts set in Windows, you can see the output voltage is actually just under 1.4 volts. The CPU power is using about 100 watts at the minute, spikes up to about 120. And obviously the input power is more than the output power because the VRM efficiency is just over there. And you can see it's about 81% efficient, and it's actually just crashed on me over here. So I'll have to look at that in a second. But yeah, that's what the EVC 2S does. So let's just see what's gone on here. It's got a blue screen of death there. Just go into the BIOS and show you the settings. Might as well while we've crashed. So we've got 4.5 GHz. Memory's at 2000, and we're at 125 on the base clock and 38 on the multiplier, which you can't see. There we go. And then, yep, 2000 on the memory. You can see the voltages here, we're running 1.425 volts. And for the load line calibration settings, you can see those there. High, 108% current. PWM frequency of 800 kHz and VTT 1.23, VCCSA 1.2, RAM's at 1.75 on both sets of channels, and bothered to set all else apart from the PLL, which is at 1.36-ish. So I don't know why it blue screened, it has been working perfectly fine with the normal 560 Ti's in both single card and SLI configuration. So I'll just boot in and try that again. It's probably a glitch or something, hopefully. So yeah, I'll just quickly show you in CPU-Z here what's going on. In Windows, you can see it says 1.448 here, but over on the laptop you can see the output voltage is only 1.4. So, but if you measure on the voltage read points on the board of a multimeter, and that's these points down here, I've got a little probe thing hooked up to there, it does actually read very similar to what's on the CPU-Z. So yeah, you can see the board and BIOS version number and everything there. Memory, 2007972468. I can't get it past 2T, I can't get it down to 1T, unfortunately, it didn't post for some reason. Those are the memory sticks I'm using. And then the other set is 5. Yeah, the other set is Ripjaws X. So I've got G-Skill Flare and G-Skill Ripjaws X in there as well. So yeah, here's the control for the MSI. We've got memory control and auxiliary voltage control. You don't really need this unless you're running LN2. The core voltage and memory goes up to plus 150 and plus 50. And the way you get these extra voltages here is when MSI afterburner detects it's got a power addition or a lightning card. You can go into settings here, and when you unlock the voltage control, you need to select extended MSI. And yeah, then you can get these extra features, and that applies for both AMD and Intel cards. So I've got a few profiles set up here, but I'm going to start off with this one. Unfortunately, the profile doesn't enable the extra memory voltage, so I have to set that manually. But you can see the fan speed's at 100% now, the voltage is at 1.15 volts, and GPU temperature's obviously gone up a bit of the increase in voltage, even though it's just coming back down again for some reason. Maybe because it's not under any load. Anyway, I'm going to run 3D Mark 11 again first. Off we go. Right, we've got the first score with the 448, we're at 7,695 with 6,850 on the graphics score and 7,219 on combine. So we're going to go up to 2,100 on the memory and see how it goes, basically. Temperature wise, only got up to 48 degrees, so it's nice and cool. And should stay nice and cool. Picked up a few points by outing the memory a little bit more here. So that was at 2100 on the memory, 960 on the core. Still 48 degrees Celsius max, and we're at 7719. Now the graphics score, I've had this over 7,000, so, and I think I've had this at 7,500, so we've still got quite a way to go yet. So, let's carry on. Score's creeping up, a little bit faster each time. Still creeping up, we've just got 7,799, we still haven't got 7,000 on the graphics score yet though. So that's the settings we're at now, 970 on the core and 2300 on the memory. I've just increased the memory and the core a little bit more, and we have smashed through the 7800 barrier. But we're not quite up to 7000 on the graphics and not quite up to 7500 on the combined. So we've still got a little bit more left in it yet, but it's getting pretty good now. Might hit 7,900, doubt we'll hit 8,000, but who knows, we'll see. It's quite a bit cooler in here, so you never know. So there we go, we've managed to run at 985 MHz, and we have broken the 7,900 barrier quite spectacularly. Graphics score well over 7,000 and combined over 7,500 now. And I guess we'll try 990 next. See how that goes. So it has actually just given up and triggered 995 MHz. I knew it wouldn't do 1,000, so maxed out at 990. So we're not going to get 8,000 points, unfortunately. Probably could stick it underwater and get a few extra megahertz out of it, but I still don't know whether we'd hit 1,000. But maximum temperature was 49 degrees, so pretty decent temp still. I think we just need a little bit more voltage, maybe some water cooling, and it'd get over 1,000. But that's it for this card on 3D Mark 11. So now I'm going to reset it and move on to 3D Mark Vantage. There we go, we have the first Vantage score, 33,936, 65,600 on the CPU and 29,232 on the GPU. So that was at 980 and 2333. Before I got 28,000 on the GPU, so this is actually a higher GPU score. So I go to 985. See if that passes. Off we go. And there we go. We've broken 34,000 at 985 megahertz. Now I'll go to 990 and see if it'll run that. And probably won't run 995 because it crashed on 3D Mark 11 at that as well, but we'll see. So unfortunately, it has crashed at 990 there, so that is a bit of a shame. But to 985, 34,000 points, which isn't too bad. So I think I'm going to leave it there for now. And got over 34,000 though, so that was pretty good on the MSI card actually. I might do one more run. With 2366 memory, bump that up. See if that does anything. It'll probably crash again though, to be fair. We'll see. So I've actually carried on messing around with it for a bit, and I have managed to get a new high score, and I've managed to get it working at 1,000 megahertz. No idea how, but I don't know. It is going at 1,000. It's just passed. Obviously I had to drop the memory back down because that crashed, so I thought I'd just go for 995 and then 1,000, and it's worked. So we're on 34,465 now, and GPU score's nearly at 30k, so I'm just going to carry on until it crashes again basically, which this might be the last score, I don't know, we'll see. And there we go, it did just crash at 1010, so 1,000 was the limit. I thought it was anyway, it was pretty much on the limit as it was. So that was actually the last score. So yeah, that is it for this card. That's it for today as well. I'm going to do SLI another day because, like I said earlier, I haven't tested the EVGA card yet, so I need to test that separately to this, and then I'll know what kind of clocks to put them at in SLI together. Well, I'm pretty sure the EVGA card is slower than this MSI one. The MSI one seems pretty quick. So yeah, that's it for this one. Goodbye.